Welcome to Multiple Spanning Tree Protocol. How to configure MSTP features, specifying the MST region configuration and enabling MSTP for two or more switches to be in the same MST region. They must have the same VLAN to instance mapping, the same configuration revision number, and the same name. A region can have one member or multiple members with the same MST configuration. Each member must be capable of processing RSTP BPD use. There is no limit to the number of MST regions in a network, but each region can only support up to 65 spanning tree instances. You can assign a VLAN to only one spanning tree instance at a time. Enables privileged exec mode. Enters global configuration mode. Enters MST configuration mode. Maps VLANs to an MST instance. For instance, ID and VLAN, the range is 0 to 4094. When you map VLANs to an MST instance, the mapping is incremental, and the VLANs specified in the command are added to or removed from the VLANs that were previously mapped. Specifies the configuration name. The name string has a maximum length of 32 characters and is case sensitive. Specifies the configuration revision number. The range is 0 to 65535. Verifies your configuration by displaying the pending configuration, applies all changes, and returns to global configuration mode. Enables MSTP. RSTP is also enabled. Changing spanning tree modes can disrupt traffic because all spanning tree instances are stopped for the previous mode and restarted in the new mode. You cannot run both MSTP and PVST+, or both MSTP and Rapid PVST+ at the same time. Returns to privileged exec mode. Configuring the root device. This procedure is optional. Before you begin, a multiple spanning tree, MST, must be specified and enabled on the device. You must also know the specified MST instance ID. Configuring a secondary root device. When you configure a device with the extended system ID support as the secondary root, the device priority is modified from the default value, 32,768, to 28,672. The device is then likely to become the root device for the specified instance if the primary root device fails. This is assuming that the other network devices use the default device priority of 32,768 and therefore are unlikely to become the root device. You can execute this command on more than one device to configure multiple backup root devices. Use the same network diameter and hello time values that you used when you configured the primary root device. This procedure is optional. Before you begin, a multiple spanning tree, MST, must be specified and enabled on the device. You must also know the specified MST instance ID. Configuring the device priority. This procedure is optional. Exercise care when using this command. Changing the priority of a device makes it more likely to be chosen as the root device, whether it is a standalone device or a device in the stack. Note, for normal network configurations, we recommend that you use the spanning tree MST ID root primary and the spanning tree MST ID root secondary global configuration commands to specify a device as the root or secondary root device. You should modify the device priority only in circumstances where these commands do not work. Configuring port priority. If a loop occurs, the MSTP uses the port priority when selecting an interface to put into the forwarding state. You can assign higher priority values, lower numerical values, to interfaces that you want selected first and lower priority values, higher numerical values, that you want selected last. If all interfaces have the same priority value, the MSTP puts the interface with the lowest interface number in the forwarding state and blocks the other interfaces. Note, if the device is a member of a device stack, you must use the spanning tree MST, instance ID, cost interface configuration command instead of the spanning tree MST, instance ID, port. Priority interface configuration command to select a port to put in the forwarding state. Assign lower cost values to ports that you want selected first and higher cost values to ports that you want selected last. Configuring path cost. This procedure is optional. A lower path cost represents higher speed transmission. The MSTP path cost default value is derived from the media speed of an interface. If a loop occurs, the MSTP uses cost when selecting an interface to put in the forwarding state. You can assign lower cost values to interfaces that you want selected first and higher cost values that you want selected last. If all interfaces have the same cost value, the MSTP puts the interface with the lowest interface number in the forwarding state and blocks the other interfaces. The show spanning tree MST interface gigabit Ethernet 101 displays information only for ports that are in a link-up operational state. Otherwise, you can use the show running config command to confirm the configuration. Configuring the hello time. This procedure is optional. The hello time is the time interval between configuration messages generated and sent by the root device. Enables privileged exec mode. Enters global configuration mode. Configures the hello time for all MST instances. The hello time is the time interval between configuration messages generated and sent by the root device. These messages indicate that the device is alive. 4 seconds, the range is 1 to 10, the default is 3. Returns to privileged exec mode. Specifying the link type to ensure rapid transitions. This procedure is optional. If you connect a port to another port through a point-to-point link and the local port becomes a designated port, the RSTP negotiates a rapid transition with the other port by using the proposal agreement handshake to ensure a loop-free topology. By default, a link type is controlled from the duplex mode of the interface. A full duplex port is considered to have a point-to-point connection. A half duplex port is considered to have a shared connection. If you have a half duplex link physically connected point-to-point to a single port on a remote device running MSTP, you can override the default setting of the link type and enable rapid transitions to the forwarding state. Designating the neighbor type. This procedure is optional. A topology could contain both pre-standard and 802.1s standard compliant devices. By default, ports can automatically detect pre-standard devices, but they can still receive both standard and pre-standard BPD use. When there is a mismatch between a device and its neighbor, only the SIST runs on the interface. You can choose to set a port to send only pre-standard BPD use. The pre-standard flag appears in all the show commands, even if the port is in STP compatibility mode. Configures the forward time for all MST instances. The forwarding delay is the number of seconds a port waits before changing from its spanning tree learning and listening states to the forwarding state. 4 seconds, the range is 4 to 30, the default is 20. Configures the maximum aging time for all MST instances. The maximum aging time is the number of seconds a device waits without receiving spanning tree configuration messages before attempting a reconfiguration. 4 seconds, the range is 6 to 40, the default is 20. Specifies the number of hops in a region before the BPDU is discarded, and the information held for a port is aged. For hop count, the range is 1 to 255, the default is 20. Restarting the protocol migration process. This procedure restarts the protocol migration process and forces renegotiation with neighboring devices. It reverts the device to MST mode. It is needed when the device no longer receives 802.1 dBPDUs after it has been receiving them. Follow these steps to restart the protocol migration process, force the renegotiation with neighboring devices, on the device.